Good morning everyone. This video we are going to discuss about control engineering closed loop system. Okay, in the closed loop system already we discussed about that is the input is dependent on the output system. Okay, so in the output system, so when whatever the output feedback value it has given, according to that input system has giving the input to the controllers. Okay, so in this system, which the control action depends on the output, in closed loop control system the actuating error signal, which is difference between input signal and the feedback signal, is fed into the controller. So in this closed loop system, the feedback system is generate the error signals according to the whatever the error signal has to be providing by the feedback signal, that again the input signal it provides the inputs towards to the controller over here. The elements of the closed loop system are command, reference, input, the error detector, control element, controlled system, and feedback element. So here elements are command, reference, input, error detector, control element, and controlled system will be the, and feedback system is the elements over in the closed loop system. Then come and see the block diagram of the closed loop system. So first input signal it will be generates the reference input, and it will be passing over the control and provide the output signal as a controlled output as a CFT. Okay, then again the CFT it will be goes to the feedback element, and the feedback element it provides the error signal or feedback signal to the reference input system. According to the reference input system, it is going to based on the required signal as well as the error input signal. Based on those things, it will be providing the input signal to the controller. Okay, then controller it will passes to the process, then the output has to be get down like this. So like this way that closed loop system has to be works over here. Okay, the reference signal is used to control the error signal into the input signal, and also it provides the required input signal to the controller over here. Okay, so like that it will be worse, and finally you can get it as a constant output over with the help of this closed loop control system. Okay, the main aim of the feedback system is to check the output signal into the input signal, and it provide the error signal over here. So that error signal with help of the reference system, it gives the required input signal to the controller over here. So the process is continuously takes place, and finally with help of that we can get the constant output over here. So here the input, whatever the input value we are given, that will be based on the whatever the output signal it will provide by the feedback element. According to that, input signal has to be sending over here in the closed loop control system. Okay, so here R of T is the reference input, and C of T is the controlled output, and B of T is the feedback signal, and E of T is the error signal. Okay, and U of T is already we know that is actuating signal that will be comes in between the controller and the process. Okay, so like this way it has to be works the closed loop control system. Okay, so here one more thing, the feedback element is present, so the feedback element is providing the error signal. Okay, so that these are all the points has to be remember over in the closed loop control systems. Then comes into the closed loop control system, the advantages of the closed loop control system is the accuracy is very high, and it senses changes in output due to the environmental parametric changes, internal disturbances, etc., and correct are the same. and also it will not affect by the any external disturbances, and also bandwidth will be high and facilitates automation system. Mainly it will be used over in the automation system. And also disadvantages of the disadvantages of the closed loop system. It is complicated design, and the maintenance and the car maintenance it will be more, and as well as it is a costlier system, and sometimes it may be the system it will be unstable. Then comes it to here the feedback signal. The feedback signal practically the feedback signal a feedback is the property of the system by which if permits the output to be compared with the reference input to generate the error signal based on which the appropriate controlling action can be decided over here. So that is the function of the feedback element over here. So usually it is used to compare with the reference output signal is used to compare with the reference input signal. With the help of that it has to be produce the error signal. So with the help of that error signal it will be used to control the entire process over here. So that is the function of the feedback signal over here. Then advantages, disadvantages, that comes to concepts of feedback. So again, the feedback system is that which part of output is fed back into the input. In feedback system, corrective action starts only after the output has been affected. Once the anything is to be changed in the output values, then only the feedback is start to working, then the corrective action takes place, then again it provided the controlled output. So the controlled output constantly comes in the required values, it will not affect the process. Okay, once the value has to be changes over here, then the feedback start to work and try to provide the constant output or controlled output in the system. Okay, so usually the main function it is used to control check compare the reference input and to the output value and provide the error signal. Due to the error signal, whatever the input value we are given, that has to be changed over in the controller over here. So this is the concept of feedback over here. Okay, so there are so many things to remember over in the this thing. Here there are so many component and feedback element has to be present over here. So due to that also the cost of the system it will be more. So first initially the required output has to be measured. So the required output is comes as per the value, it will not affect the process. And also the once if any value it will be changes over here, then only the feedback element start to work. It compares the output value into the reference value. Okay, then it provided the error signal. That error according to the error signal, the reference transducer it produced the required input. So here R of here the R of T is the reference input, U of T is the actuating value, and C of T is the controlled output, B of T is the error signal. Okay, sorry, B of T is the feedback signal and E of T is the error signal over here. So after comparing here, error signal has to be provided over here. Then finally, we are getting as a required output. Thank you.